Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Let's shift focus to Sarda Energy. That's the next talk in focus. Remember, they posted a rather good set of numbers actually in the first quarter. But what's the outlook post that? It seems the street is already excited. The stock has already moved to the high point of the day. But let's understand what's going on and what's the outlook from here on. We have with us Mr. Padam Jain, the director and CFO of the company. Hi, Mr. Jain. Thanks so much, sir, for joining in. Well, sir, we wanted to ask you, firstly, what is the current prices? If you could give us a sense of what are the pellet prices currently in comparison to quarter one. Similarly, with regard to sponge prices, what was it? What is it currently? And if you can compare it with quarter one average?
Yeah, the currently prices of pellet and sponge have moved up substantially. As compared to the average realization of 5,900 in the first quarter, our present pellet price is hovering around 7,300.
Oh.
And in case of sponge iron, our average realization was 19,000. Now it is hovering around 23,000 present price. So there is a substantial increase in the prices as compared to the average realization of the first quarter.
Okay. Mr. Jain, that's a big jump, right, in realizations. Is it sustainable?
Marginal, there may be some marginal corrections. Presently, there has been substantial export, but yes, definitely more or less prices will remain sustainable, it appears. There may be, because there is a sharp increase, there may be some correction from this level, marginal.
So what has caused this kind of a jump in prices, pellet prices at 7,300? Is there good demand coming in from China? Are you exporting or is it...
There are substantial exports from India.
Okay.
That has created a demand for pellets.
So you are exporting as well?
Yeah, we are also exporting.
So all this increase that you're talking about, it's all for exports or is even in the domestic market we're seeing such robust pricing, particularly for pellets?
Yeah, it is even in the domestic market because ultimately price parity will always be there. If someone is getting a price high price in export market, they'll always shift there to automatically demand supply in domestic market will change and the price of a domestic market will also come at par with the international market.
Okay.
So this increase in prices is purely on account of demand, higher demand, and what are the kind of sales volumes you've seen in Q1? And if you could share some outlook for the full year, you know, your expectation of sales or volume guidance.
No, last year our average sales was 1 lakh tons per quarter.
Okay.
And totally we had sold about 4 lakh tons. This year we have already sold 1,50,000 tons in the first quarter.
Okay. This year, so this year referring quarter. To pellets, right?
Yeah, pellets. We are talking about the pellets. Last year our run rate was 1 lakh tons per quarter.
Okay. And this 1.5 lakh tons per quarter in terms of pellet sales, is this kind of a volume run rate sustainable for the full year? Can we hit 6 lakh tons?
Yeah, we expect to maintain the volume.
Okay, so 6 lakh tons is what you're looking at for this year. All right, sir. So if you could tell us also, sir, about your deleveraging plan. I remember the last time you joined us, you told us your total consolidated debt was around 1,050 crores, if I got that number right, correct?
Yeah, right, right. Long-term debts.
Okay, so do you plan on reducing your debt from those levels, if you could give us a sense? And also, what is your borrowing cost? You were telling us last time that you were looking at refinancing your loans. Have you done that?
No, so far as this leveraging is concerned, our total long-term loan remains more or less at the same level. At consolidated level, at standalone level, the debt is company is almost debt-free at the net level, net of the liquid investments. At standalone level, we are at zero debt.
No, sir, we are talking about consolidated debt level.
Consolidated, we are maintaining at the same level. What is happening? We are paying certain debts on the due dates, but at the same time, we are also availing fresh loans for our ongoing projects, particularly for our hydropower project. So, our long-term loan remains at the more or less at the same level of 1,050 crores.
Okay. Mr. Jain, you're talking about a sharp increase in your volumes. Your pellet volumes will go up from 4 lakh tons on an annual basis to 6 lakh tons per, you know, on an annual basis. Prices itself are on an upward trajectory, a sharp increase. Give us a sense of the kind of overall sales as well as margins you expect for the full year, FY19.
Yeah, as compared to last year, there should be minimum 5 to 7 basis points improvement in the margins.
5 to 7 basis points or 5?
Yeah, percentage
points.
EBITDA.
No, percentage points or basis
points? Percentage
point.
Percentage points.
So 5.
Percentage points.
All right.
All right.
Compared to the previous year.
Okay. So if you are looking at a sales volume number, what is the total sales you are expecting? And if you are saying 5 to 7%, that means you are working with around a 23% margin for this year?
Current year, ma?
Yeah, for the current year.
Yeah. We expect to have margin around that.
A margin level. Around 23%.
Yeah.
Margins around 23%, and top line should be what? In the first quarter itself, you have grown by more than 25%. So for the year, what kind of a sales?
We have, our revenue has increased by 17% YOY.
Okay, so what kind of a number, sir, are you looking at for the year?
We can assume the similar increase in the annual basis. Also.
So 2,500 crores is doable?
Should be.
Okay.
Depends upon the pricing, also volume is there. Definitely both way we will have the increase on account of the price as well as on account of the volume.
Mr. Jain, you're sounding very confident. You know, and we have to tell you that from the minute you appeared on the channel and from the time you started giving us your commentary, your stock is up nearly around 5.5% approximately. Wanted to ask you this question, sir. Your stock price has fallen from around 600 rupees to sub 400 rupees.
Yeah.
Any possibility of the promoters coming and supporting the stock at these levels? I know you already have more than 72.5% in the company, but will the promoter, you know, look at increasing a stake? Given that you're saying everything's so positive.
No, promoters are already holding, as you told me, we are already holding 72.5%. And at appropriate time, if in past also gradually we have increased, not in a big way. Gradually, whenever required, whenever we found the opportunity, we have always invested.
Okay,
four quarters we have increased the...
All right, you're keeping it open-ended, sir. So let's talk about your total coal requirement. What is your total coal requirement? How much of that are you getting via linkage? And are you receiving all the linkage? Because, you know, a lot of customers tell us that only power plants are getting coal, you know, and some of you guys are not getting it. Give us some clarity there.
No, there is a delay in receipt of the quantity of the linkage. What happened, actually, whatever we were getting through rake movement, there was a problem. Because rakes were not available, most of the rakes were diverted to the independent power producer.
So what is your total requirement in a year?
We have got our rake allotment converted into by road.
Okay.
So as to get the full quantity.
Okay, so what is your requirement, sir? A total coal requirement in a year?
Our requirement is somewhere about 9 lakh tons.
9 lakh tons per annum. How much of it are you getting by linkage?
About 70% plus we are getting through linkage, 70%.
And now you're going to be bringing this coal via road instead of via rail. So there'll be an additional cost.
Part of that we will be, the ratio of the by road will increase, not 100%. Part of that will still be coming through by rake. But part of that we are bringing through by road also, so as to increase the quantity, lifting quantity.
Okay, all right. Thanks so much, Mr. Jain, for joining in and giving us that positive commentary. The steel market, Reema, is looking very, very buoyant. It's a monsoon season, but for the first time in many years, I am seeing that prices in the monsoon quarter are higher than the first quarter. So, you know, the second quarter should look very, very good for a lot of these companies. And as Mr. Jain is telling us, the coal availability as well is a problem for some of these sponge iron producers. They require thermal coal, not the coking coal. So, you know, that's something else that we should keep in mind. Stock moves to the high point of the day.